Joining us now is PhilHealth spokesperson, Ms. Shirley Domingo. Ms. Domingo, thank you for taking our call. Good morning.
Hello, good morning, Sir Mike, and good morning to everyone who's listening and watching this program.
Mm-hmm. Ms. Domingo, let's begin with the situation in Iloilo. 7 hospitals have decided to sever ties with PhilHealth over 895 million pesos worth of unpaid claims. What happened here?
Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Hello? What happened in Iloilo? Can you hear me, Domingo?
Yeah, I can hear you, but it's choppy. But anyway, this is about the Iloilo situation. Actually, we are reconciling the figures because they gave us a figure which is more than our actual in-process claims. They have included figures or amounts that were of claims that were returned to hospitals and denied. And on our side, we cannot pay for claims that are returned to the hospital unless they refile it with us. So we're still hoping that this reconciliation of figures will be recognized and will push through.
Mm-hmm. Dr. Domingo, they cited a December 20 meeting with PhilHealth officers, but they said nothing supposedly came out of it. PhilHealth was supposedly citing a debit-credit payment method, which you also mentioned in your press release. Explain to us what this method means and how different is this from the previous method?
Okay, the debit-credit payment method is a way of fast-tracking funds given to hospitals based on claims that are already in our offices. Now, we already released around 11 plus billion for DCPM 1 and 2, and we are offering DCPM 3 to hospitals nationwide as long as they are managing at least one case of COVID. The difference between the 1 and 2 and the 3 is that we're giving a bigger amount now. Before, we were only giving 60% of the total computed amount. But the hospitals wanted more of that amount, and therefore we increased it to 80% of the total amount agreed.
So what happens here, ma'am?
Of course, minus 2% tax.
So what happens under this method, ma'am? You advance payment. Help us explain to us what happens under this method.
I'm sorry, but you're coming in very not clear. Can you please repeat the question?
Yes, sure. Explain to us, ma'am, exactly what happens under this method. Are advances given to the hospitals and then accounted for after? What exactly happens? If you could just lay it out for us.
At first, we compute the amount of claims, good claims, the pending claims that are in our offices at the moment for that particular hospital. Once we compute that amount, as they have first to give us a letter of intent that they will avail of this DCPM. So once we compute that amount, we determine 80% amount, and we give it to the hospital at once. And reconciliation of the claims or processing of the claims will happen, and any return to hospital or denied claims will be removed from the remaining 20%. So after reconciliation is done, that's when we release the remaining 20% minus 2% tax.
Mm-hmm.
So and they're complaining
They're supposedly complaining about this because they were saying that this was supposedly unilaterally implemented. They were supposedly not consulted. Is this true?
I'm sorry. Again, sorry.
Some hospitals are complaining about this method, ma'am, because they're saying they were not consulted. Was this unilaterally implemented?
Let me clarify that this method was cleared with the different agencies and officers it's necessary to get the clearance. No? And we are orienting our hospitals, all our regions have oriented our hospitals on this method of claims. And they are not required to avail if they don't want to. But we are encouraging them to avail because it will be a way of fast-tracking funds to these hospitals.
Mm-hmm.
Around 11 billion, around 300 or 400 hospitals nationwide.
All right. Now, was this method in effect already when the claims were made, or was this introduced somewhere along the way? And the question is, if it were not already in existence when the claims were made, why change the rules in the middle of the ballgame, so to speak?
We still continue to process claims in the regular way. These claims, this DCPM will be able to give the hospitals the necessary funds even while we are still processing claims. And therefore, it will be beneficial actually to them. And if they will submit their letter of intent. But as I said earlier, they need not submit if they don't want to utilize or avail of this method. And the regular processing will still continue. So it's not like we're abolishing the regular claims processing. We're still doing the regular claims processing. So this is just a way of giving the funds at once while we are doing the processing.
If that's the case, ma'am, that you are supposedly going to give 80% of the estimated claims, why are the hospitals in Iloilo, other hospitals like FEU, objecting to this?
Actually, we already had a meeting with FEU, and they are amenable to continuing the reconciliation meetings, reconciliation on the amounts, and they have indicated that they might avail of the DCPM 3.
What about the Iloilo hospital?
Our president himself met with them in Iloilo, and we offered them the DCPM 3. I think agreed with the amount because they are including return to hospital and denied claims as part of our payables, which unfortunately, because of rules that we have to follow and guidelines, we cannot pay for claims that are returned to the hospitals unless they refile those claims with us because it's not with us anymore.
Mm-hmm. So you're saying, ma'am, there are other issues. Now, in August, ma'am, we talked to you about COA's findings flagging 118 million pesos worth of rejected claims from six hospitals. What has become of this? Is this part of the 11.65 billion peso payment under the debit-credit payment method in your press statement?
No. You're asking about denied claims?
Yes, ma'am. The
denied claims can be appealed by the hospitals. So there are different reasons for denial. And actually, the number one reason is the hospitals are filing it beyond the required 120 days to file claims under this pandemic. Before it was 60 days, we extended it to 120 days. But still, many hospitals still submit the claims to us beyond 120 days, and therefore we have to deny these claims. But the hospitals can still appeal for payment of these claims. So there's a process of handling these denied claims.
Now, I'm talking specifically about the six hospitals flagged in the COA report, ma'am. Would you know the status of their rejected claims? Have their appeals been resolved? Because it's beyond 120 days, if we count from August.
I don't know exactly the status of their denied claims. I don't know if they appealed for that, because if they don't, beyond the prescribed period, then it's denied.
Mm-hmm. Now, what seems to be the problem, ma'am, in processing the reimbursements, and why is it taking PhilHealth this long to address the problem?
Yeah, there are several reasons for the delay in COVID claims, because actually we are paying the regular claims and the COVID claims. But there are several reasons why the COVID claims are delayed. One is policy issues. There are some policies that had been for probable and confirmed cases. Another is remdesivir issue, payment of drugs and medicines that are not in the PMDF. These are policies that have to be solved not only at PhilHealth but at a higher level. But anyway, we have identified these policies and resolved most of them. And therefore, we hope that processing will be faster. Secondly, is because of the effects also of this pandemic. PhilHealth has been affected by this pandemic in terms of human resource. We followed IATF guidelines of 30% in office and then 50% in office. a lot of our people was affected by COVID and to be quarantined.
So all kind of process.
And that's why we're offering the DCPM as a way of giving funds while we are processing.
Mm-hmm. Now you have the Private Hospitals Association of the Philippines calling for a PhilHealth holiday from January 1 to 5. This means, according to them, they won't accept PhilHealth deductions on those days. How do you think this will impact your customers?
I'm sorry. Can you please repeat the question? Chatty kasi ang dating mo.
Now that the Philippine Hospitals Association of the Philippines is calling for a PhilHealth holiday from January 1 to 5, that means they won't accept PhilHealth deductions on those days. How will this impact your customers? How will this affect your customers now?
We are still hoping that hospitals will rethink their stand of not accepting PhilHealth cost members in their hospitals. It will really be the members who will be affected by this call. And we hope it will not really push through. We have been discussing this with the hospital organizations. I think the call was made by the Private Hospital Association.
Yes.
So we're hoping that these private hospitals will rethink their stand. We are continuously talking to the hospitals at the regions, and we're hoping that our reconciliation will be able to at least mitigate the effects of our delayed claims.
Mm-hmm. Ma'am, is there a funding issue with PhilHealth? Because there are some observations that if the funds are really present, why not just pay the reimbursements to settle the issue? Because this has been going on for several months now.
Again, please. Hello?
Ma'am, ask, is there a funding issue with PhilHealth? Because there are some observations that if the funds are present, why not just pay the reimbursements to settle the issue, which has been ongoing for months?
Yes, the funding issue. No, there's no funding issue. PhilHealth has enough funds to pay for all the claims that are filed with us. So the issue is not related to funds. Now, payment of claims passes through a process. We don't just pay when we receive claims. It has to be reviewed as to compensability, and it has to follow guidelines. And therefore, we need our human resource to do that. And as I said earlier, we had issues on human resource during this pandemic, which we have addressed. We have augmented our human resource in our claims processing units. We pulled out some people from our other units and put them in claims processing. But still, the effect of this pandemic is also affecting our capability to process claims. And that's why we have come up with strategies to pay our hospitals even while we are doing processing.
Mm-hmm. How is the status of your contributions or premiums collections with the members? Have you actually increased the rates recently?
We have increased the rate to 3.5 for direct members, directly paying members. So the rest was on hold, such as the OFWs, because this was a directive from Malacañang to hold their increase in payments.
So what's their current rate now at the moment?
It's 3.5%.
All right. Now, lastly, what steps are you taking to address this issue? Are you still going to talk to the Private Hospitals Association of the Philippines or to hospitals in Iloilo regarding their move?
Yes, we are still hoping to talk to these hospitals, continuously talking to PHAPI and Dr. Degrano specifically. And he knows exactly what's happening in PhilHealth. We orient them, we update them on what's happening in all the issues that they bring up. So we still continuously talk with them regarding this.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, despite signal difficulties, Dr. Shirley Domingo of
Thank you very much, friend. Thank you very much.